Mekhala here from poojas.in. I have here two of my Guru Bhandavas, Shalini ji. You must have watched her on other videos also. And I have a special guest again, that's Deepti Tarakner. So she is my Guru Bhandava again. And they all had doubts and they wanted to seek some answers for the upcoming Guru transit. So over to them.
Okay, Mekhala, thank you for giving me an opportunity to ask your questions. in our life we hear of so many transits, you know. Sometimes there is Guru transit, sometimes there is Shani transit. And likewise, you know, there are so many things which are happening. So when we come to know about this, what should be our attitude or our mentality, or how do we go about in our daily life when such a transit happens?
Okay, so as soon as you hear about a transit, what you need to do is you look at it only as an opportunity. First of all, what happens is every transit comes with two kinds of results. One is it's either very favorable for you or it's very bad. So medium or average, there's nothing like that. So when something is really very bad, then what happens is 1 month before the transit, you start getting some kind of symptoms.
Okay.
You can experience that. Mm-hmm. You know, suddenly things have started moving and you're getting opportunities. So that means, you know, that there's a change in the transit, or maybe there's something, it's something to do with the dasha, the ruling period of a particular planet. So you have to be observant, first of all, how your life is going on every day. So I want to give you an example. Chandra also transits every 2.5 days once. So when the moon transits, there is an impact on the mind, which is why one day you're in a good mood, the other day you're not, because Chandra is the one which makes the movement very fast. So not like a Guru pulled with 1 year once, 2.5 years once is Shani, Rahu's 1.5 years once. So like that, you know, each planet, it's a different time frame. But you have to be observant. I am so observant to the extent that if I don't get sleep on a particular night, mm-hmm. I check whether either Chandra is Uccha or Nicha, like whether he's debilitated or he's exalted. Okay. So when he's exalted, you may be very hyperactive.
Okay.
And when he's debilitated, when he's in Vrishchika Rashi, you may feel like very low, sad, irritated, like that. So that's how much the planets impact your mind and your life. So if suddenly there are accidents happening, or suddenly you know, somebody wants to get married, they start getting proposals, and you know, there is movement. So then you should know that, okay, there is a transit or something maybe happening, which is why suddenly there is a movement in my life. So you have to be observant is the first thing that I want to tell you. Secondly, if negative things start happening, you have to take quick action. So you consult your astrologer or your guru and you just report what is happening. And then take measures which will prevent further damage. See, because Guru transit or Shani transit is something which happens for a long time. The impact is there for more than a year or a year. So you can't be suffering for 1 year. There has to be a solution for that. So quickly you can take a remedial measure, and at the time of transit, when you do the puja, so you know, if you know that somebody has a negative intention, you want to correct that person, right? You want to go and convince that person not to take those negative measures. That's exactly what we do in a transit puja. So just at the time of transit, we pray to that particular deity so that there is no negative impact of that planet during that one full year's period, that time, you know. So that is exactly what you also need to do. You have to be watching what's happening in your life. You can't be leading your life mechanically.
Okay.
Then the planets will go on ruling. You'll be like the wind. Whichever side the wind blows, and you are you know, on that side, and suddenly you fall, you get up, you know, these things. If you have to scale up, you have to go forward in life, you want to avoid all these hurdles, then you have to take measures. So for that, one thing is the transit pujas which you do. The second thing is the sadhana that you can do in your house.
So what do you suggest? What kind of sadhana should we do?
So I'll just talk about the upcoming Guru transit. So maybe what kind of sadhana you should do for the Guru.
Okay.
So Guru Bhagwan is Shubha Graha, so he usually does good things to everybody.
Mm-hmm.
But if he is not favorable during the transit, so for example, if he is going to be an 8th Guru from your Rashi, then what happens is you get Prana Sankat, we call it. Like, you know, you experience difficulties and challenges which are equivalent to you know, life taking kind of a thing. It will be that challenging, but it's not a threat to your life because Guru is a Shubha Graha.
Mm-hmm.
So if it was Rahu, you have to be careful. You know, if the Rahu transit is bad, then accidents are guaranteed. So, but Guru won't make it that worse. But he will give you hints. He'll give you injuries. He'll give you indications. Somebody coming and hitting your car, but nothing happens to you. You know, like that, I'm saying. So I'm not referring only to accidents, but I'm saying challenges will be like that. Like breathtaking kind of, you know, my God, it was such a challenging thing. Oh, like that you feel end of the, not end of the transit. As it starts only, you'll feel it's like a roller coaster ride. So you have to do sadhanas. Mm-hmm. Like for Guru, what is most lovable for Guru is when you are in spirituality. That's what Guru likes. So although it's Deva Guru, we're talking about planet Jupiter. The moment you align yourself to spirituality, he will start giving you benefic results. He will reduce the malefic results. Mm-hmm. So reading the Guru Charitra or Sai Sat Charitra, visiting the Dattatreya temple or Dakshinamurti temple, giving channa, like, you know, the kadale we call it. So, you know, offering it as nevedyam and distributing it free.
See, Shirdi Baba temple also?
Yeah, Shirdi Baba temple. So Shirdi Sai Sat Charitra if you read,
yeah,
that is also very good. When you do these things or lighting a ghee lamp, mm-hmm, before Guru every Thursday,
mm-hmm,
that's very good. If you can light it every day, it's the best. But if you can't, at least on a Thursday, you should recognize Guru's importance in your life.
So now, I think Ahan is going through Guru chants with my son.
Yeah.
So what do you think, what should he be doing now? What are the important things he should be doing?
So Ahan is a student, right?
Yeah.
So he's studying. So for him, Guru will help him in education,
mm-hmm,
and instilling right kind of samskaras,
mm-hmm,
getting the right frame of mind.
Mm-hmm.
So what he needs to do is visiting a temple is the best.
Mm-hmm.
Like every Thursday, if he can visit the Guru temple,
mm-hmm,
any Guru,
mm-hmm,
Dattatreya, Dakshinamurti, any of these temples he can visit. He can donate yellow color t-shirts or some, you know, nice interesting clothes for children, small children,
mm-hmm,
in yellow.
Mm-hmm.
And he can also like yellow color crayons, pencils, because mm-hmm, yellow is Guru's favorite color,
mm-hmm,
Jupiter. So these are the things which he can do from his end, like make a conscious effort.
Mm-hmm.
Or he can even light ghee lamps, because nowadays I see a lot of youngsters like do all these things. So he can light ghee lamps and he can do the decoration of the Guru photo, what you have,
mm-hmm,
your Atma Guru, whoever it is. So you can do the decoration, light lamps, light agarbatti,
mm-hmm,
you can sing a few bhajans. Or you could also chant the Guru Gita. He can do all these things.
Okay.
So both of you can do. So it's not like only his Guru is going to be good or bad. So I'll do. He should do. I shouldn't be doing. It's not like that.
Both. So I can also do. As a mother, I can definitely,
yes,
do all this.
Yes.
So that means what you're saying is that it's not necessary that my son has to do, even the mother can do something.
You can do not on his behalf. You can do with him.
Okay.
You can participate with him.
Okay.
It's good because you also have Guru in your chart.
Mm-hmm.
So you also have some role. Guru has some role in your life.
Mm-hmm.
So you join him.
Mm-hmm.
So more the merrier. But
okay,
it's not like only whoever is affected should do and who is not affected should not. Everybody can do.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And it's good to do.
No, it's not like if I did it and he didn't do it, it's not the same.
No, it's not the same.
He should do it and I'm just going to be participating.
Yes, it's like this. He has to eat his meal, you have to eat yours.
Okay.
It's like that.
Okay.
So he has to do his prayers, you do yours.
No. So in her case, the child is big enough and old enough.
Yeah, he's in college, right?
Yeah, he's 18 years. Yeah.
So what if the children are small? I mean, if they are under the age of 5? Below 5 years of age?
See, below 5 years of age, only when they have Bala Rishta Dosha, they you know, face problems. Otherwise, as per the Vidura Niti, children are not affected by karma or these planets. So you will be anyway doing many things like Jataka Karma and then the Juttu,
yeah,
you know, there's a ceremony to cut the hair. So those things if you go on doing from time to time, that's good enough.
So that's the protection for the child.
That's the protection for the child. Whatever is required at that age, you need to do Akshara Abhyasa. So everything you just align to divinity and whatever they do, Anna Prashna. So you know, when you feed first time, you go in a temple, do a puja and do it. All these things when you're doing, they'll be in order.
So I have a question for you, Mekhala. Now you were saying that the Guru transit has positive impacts and also negative impacts,
yeah,
right? So when it's negative, typically anybody will go to an astrologer most probably and ask for the remedial measures and they will do it. What happens if somebody, when it's favorable, and what if somebody is like, you know, complacent about that?
It's better not to be complacent. So you should, when you know, when good things are happening,
mm-hmm,
you should always count your blessings.
Mm-hmm.
So that is one thing that you need to do, whether it's for Guru.
No, I'm counting my blessings, but I'm not. I mean, I'm not doing anything beyond counting my blessings.
then you will remain as it is. Whatever karma throws at you, whether it's good or bad, and that particular transit result, that you'll experience. So when whatever ball comes, you'll be hitting that ball. Okay. So you won't get a chance.
So when you do intense sadhana, when you do take part in more remedial measures, it's not remedial in this case, but if you participate, then it amplifies the quality of your life.
It's like an icing on the cake.
It's like an icing.
Definitely.
On the cake.
Definitely.
Okay.
Any questions? I think she has answered all the questions.
Anything else about the Guru transit?
I think that's it.
Maybe I can take this opportunity to tell you how it will impact your, for example, somebody like you. If she runs a business, corporate film in your business, right?
Yeah.
What are you actually doing this?
I run a business called Shift Films. We make films. So and all kinds of visual assets.
Okay, so when you're doing that, for example, there was a Shukra transit sometime last month, where Shukra was debilitated. So when he was debilitated, I made an observation that you faced problems with your editors, computer systems were off, things were not in place. You remember that?
Yeah.
So these kind of things happen because you don't know what's happening. The same system was working fine, nobody mishandled it, and then still what happened? So that is the role of the transit.
Okay.
So when she called me for that, I immediately looked into the panchang and I saw that Shukra is debilitated. So anything creative, anything to do with creative industry will be impacted a bit. So
now there is going to be transits from time to time, right?
Yeah.
And for every, so you are saying be watchful. And if you start seeing something, you reach out to your astrologer.
Yes.
Is that what you are saying?
Reach out to the astrologer or your guru or your Ishta Devata.
Okay. Ishta Devata is spiritual.
Yes.
But as a physical, like a hotline.
Yeah, yeah.
An actual hotline. Would be my astrologer.
Yeah, sure. It should be. Don't ignore those things.
We have to be watchful about everything that is going on in our lives.
Yes. Sometimes it's nothing. None of these transits will be impacting. It will just be evil eye or jealousy of somebody. But still, if you reach out to the astrologer, the advantage is that the astrologer will tell you to take the drishti, remove the negativity from your aura. Even that will help you a lot. So it is not always the transit. That is why you should consult your astrologer. On behalf of all my viewers, I want to thank both of you for being on my show, and you're most welcome anytime you have any questions. So the whole intention of doing this exercise is mainly because she can always call me and ask for Andy. I meet her every day, so we can meet and discuss. The point is to reach out to more people. So if you have any questions and you want them answered, please go ahead and send me the questions and we will get back to you. Thank you. Namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste.